Hey, what's up, guys? It's Tommy Mars. I am back for part two of Reputation. So since I filmed the whole episode, which is the whole album, I can tell you this week, man, it's been something else listening to these songs. I had a few people drop by the studio this weekend to work on some music stuff. A lot of what I did was showing them Ready For It and Delicate. I was showing them these songs and I was like, you've got to hear this record. So I can pretty much say right now at this point, if you ask me straight away, Reputation's my favorite Taylor record right now. I mean, I really, really fell in love with Folklore a lot, but Reputation's one for me right now, and I would say Folklore is two. And then, of course, you know, I'm only through four Taylor Swift records, but right now that's how it stands for me. So that first episode, if you're keeping score, it was Ready For It, Endgame, I Did Something Bad, Don't Blame Me, and of course, Delicate, which I am so into. You know, I almost said something there, just like as I explained to you in that video. I put a video on Patreon, and it was a music video episode for Delicate, and it was so amazing. It's not on here for, I think it's obvious reasons, you know. I'm telling you right now, I cannot even put an episode with a music video on it. It's like, gone. It don't even take a few minutes. It's gone. As soon as I upload it, it gets the axe. So, and to be honest with you, the last couple episodes I put of the music video where I couldn't put the video in the video that you're watching here on YouTube, I was catching some flack for it. And I was like, all right, man. I mean, it's cool, man. If you don't want to see it without the video, I get it. I mean, I understand and stuff. But anyway, the point of that story is, so I did a reaction video to the music video of Delicate, because that is one of those songs that I'm just like, oh, totally vibing on. And in that episode, I talked about how I had to go for a drive, and it was about 40 minutes long, and Delicate was on repeat the whole time. It's that song. It's that song for me that I just can't stop listening to. It's just so great. So beautiful. I really love that song. And then so I decided to say, hey, I'm going to watch the music video. A lot of you were like, Tommy, the music video, you mentioned the rain. Because in the first episode of this series, I talked about how there was like, the song made me feel like two people, you know, meeting at the end of a movie and it's raining or may not be raining and stuff. And people are like, dude, it rains in the video. So I watched the video. It was amazing. I also have to say that Delicate is my favorite Taylor video so far of what I've seen. Obviously, I've not seen all her music videos, but Delicate is my favorite. I love the concept. I love her playfulness. It was so good. The visuals were great. I loved it. I loved it. I loved it. So today's episode, we've got Look What You Made Me Do, So It Goes, Gorgeous, Getaway Car, and King of My Heart. These are the five songs we're covering today, and I'm excited to share part two with you. Okay, if you want to get at me on the socials, TOMMYMARZBAND, Tommy Mars Band, drop in and say cello. And then, like I said before, if you want to see this entire series, it's already up on Patreon, uncut, as well as that music video episode. All right, let's get to this. This is part two, Reputation. I will see you guys next week, right back here for part three. Let's get on to this next song, and it's Look What You Made Me Do. Now, the thing is, I know this song, and I have actually heard this song, but for some reason, well, maybe I'm not thinking of the same one. I thought there was one, it was right after Shake It Off, so that's why maybe it can't be that. And I thought it was one like, I don't know, she was in a car or something, or was she going after an ex-boyfriend? Something. I'm vaguely remember. All I remember, actually, I remember it from Twitter. I remember people kind of were losing their minds, and there was a lot of hate for it. And that's what I remember, actually, the most out of all of it. So maybe I got the wrong song, because I thought it was right after Shake It Off, but I know that's on 1989. Well, I guess, let me hear it. I remember hearing it, but not hearing it, like being into it, like giving it like a full listen. So let me quit yapping and get to it. All right, this is Look What You Made Me Do. No, this is the song. This is the song. Okay. My timeline might be. Psh. Oh. God, I love the snares on this record. Yeah, because there's like a Look What You Made Me or something. Here's our claps. Are they gonna double? Like a. They didn't. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Look what you made me do. Look what you just made me do. Look what you just made me do. I mean, this is a solid build up for it to just boom. Oh, okay. A little double time on the hat. That's nice. Oh, all right, little skip. I love it. Yo. Okay, so that is a solid pop song that should be a single. That should be all in dashes. Because it really does. It really has so many elements of pop goodness, dance goodness, strong vocal. And for that is, it's more so, it's not like a singing vocal. It's more like this, it's like an empowering vocal. It sticks right out in your face. And I like the way it's mixed. This album is like, her vocally wise, it's mixed just so much different than what I have heard the last couple of albums. Certainly it's completely a 180, 360. It's actually a 180 from like how Folklore is mixed vocally. But it's not that I like it, that I dislike it. I like it. I like the way it's mixed. It needs to be in your face. I mean, you couldn't have those kind of vocals, the big airy, you know, ethereal vocals like on these type of songs. I haven't had a lull yet in this album. I mean, I'm moving around. It happens. If you're anything like me, and I got a feeling that some of you probably are, you know, sometimes you can gauge it like that. Just you getting your movement out of the song, or it's making you think whatever. And I definitely feel the energy of this album, and I really, really like it so far. Are we six songs in? All right, let's go on to the next one. And this is So It Goes. So on the track listing, it had Ready For It had like the dots leading in, and this says So It Goes with the dots leading out. A lot of times, you know, it's like the bookend thing. That's what it feels like. I'm sure it's just coincidence, but I noticed it. I gotta find out. I gotta look up who produced this. I mean, it's just a way different vibe. I almost dropped my coffee. I say that, and here I come with more of a Folklore vocal mix. I just said. We're back. That was nice. That. Do it again. I really like her vocal. I like that still, but that harmony right there. This is so well put together, man. It's More that lead vocal thing I was talking about. I literally could not pick my favorite song right now. These are so, all of these are so damn good. Okay, I was going to say something. Oh, yes. So I was talking about those little spikes. Boop, I hear those in the songs. This is kind of, I feel like this is one of the first time I'm starting to rehear that on this album. The other part that got me though, she's going to a different note. So now today, as I know Taylor, is there's that minor note I talked about. Go watch Evermore Folklore. It's like, that note, which I love. I love when she does it. It's weird on this here, though. It's like she's about to slide into that, and she doesn't. She almost rounds it off and goes to a different place, note-wise. I like that, too. When she just did it on this song, and I should have pointed out more, but when she did it, my brain asked itself. It says, wait, which one do you like better? And I don't know that I've maybe heard the other one too much now off the last couple records. It was new. It was like that new exciting thing, you know? You know, when you meet somebody first time, it's new and exciting, but after a year, you hate them. So I feel like that was different and new enough where it stimulated my brain. I was like, oh, I like that. I want to hear more of that. Okay, this one's called Gorgeous. Man, this album is so good. She just did the thing I was talking about. Nah, 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 nah. She just did what I was talking about in the last song. Back to back. So I got to hear both things. Wow. I don't know which one I do like better. That was nice to hear her, really. So she said older. Is this about her current boyfriend? I don't know the timeline. So is this about her current love? Does anybody know? There's that harmony that I love, that she kills. Man, that's a great top line right there. That is so good. That's a great, great harmony or a great melody. So nice. After song after song, there is no sleeper on this entire record so far. I'm a little more than halfway through it. There is no filler on this record so far. None. Zero. Zip. It's so good. You know how I get in there, and you've been watching my channel, and you've been watching me for a while. You know, I say this all the time. Live in the moment, you know? But holy smokes, man. Oh my gosh, you guys are going to kill me, but I know I'm not all the way through, but this is the best record, right? Like, even though I live more in the singer-songwriter world, like Folklore, which I love so much, but gosh, there's so many elements in it. You know, there's some dance, there's like, we're talking about the banging, you know, we're talking about the 808, but that last one gave me, it almost had like it had the new technology stuff, but it had that almost like an 80s feel-good movie feel to it. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're coming up there. It's like, it coming out of my left monitor. Just, it's almost like an emotional experience. Man, oh man. Okay. Let's go to the next song, the next vehicle. Okay, so this is Getaway Car. Hmm. It was the best again. Of times, the worst of crimes. I struck a match and blew your mind, but I didn't mean it. And you didn't see it. You know, I love reflective songs. The ties were black, the lies were white. And shades of gray and candlelight. Like, I wanted to leave. Was it Cornelia Street? That kind of feel? That's what it's giving me right now. Heard this one before. I don't know. That was nice. We'll do it again. Yeah. It sounded like a video game. It's like, it's like, boom, 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 boom. I like the cadence of that little noise. Like, it could have stayed straight, but why, right? Let's mix it up. And I love their choices of snares on this whole record. Is that like... Yeah, it is. Wow. And those little droppings of... And they just move around. Man, it's nice. Nice job on this. Oh, and she changes up. Of course. Beautiful. Wow, I love what she was climbing down there. That was nice. I mean, like with records that come out, normally, do we really say zero skips? I mean, do we really, really, really ever get that? I mean, we get it sometimes, and we get it on even some of her records, actually, but of what I've heard. But this is like full on no skip. They are all great songs. They are all great songs. And, you know, there's so many special things happening. Frankly, I feel like it's almost easy to miss some things because there's so many great things happening. Vocally, harmony, placement, mix, production, so many cool things just going on that it's almost easy to get lost because there is a lot. And there's every little bit I'll wake up and go, oh, that was cool, you know? All right, let's see what we got next. Okay, so this is King of My Heart. I'm perfectly fine. I live on my own. I made up my mind. I'm better off being alone. I like when she goes down there. Whoa. I did not see that coming. Not on that intro. Wow. Oh, this is nice. Oh man, that I like that a lot. Comes to this. She can pull it off, man. She can pull off anything. And those little tick tick. Oh man, oh man. This is production bliss right here. Woo. Oh, an acoustic guitar carrying this part. It's great, man. I love this part, man. I want to make a part like that. Damn, I like that. Yeah, yeah. Good. I'm wrong about the lead, man. She's just doing it at will on this record, and I love it. This is so good. I almost was like, GD. I mean, this is something else. Wait, are we on going to track 11? Not one time. Not one time was I was like, man, this one's good, but you know, it's not my favorite. I don't love it or whatever. And there's been those moments on every single record, but no, I can't say that. I mean, I seriously cannot straight face say that happened so far. Wow, this is crazy good. All right, I hope your New Year's is off to a great start. I will see you in the next video. It's your boy, Tommy Mars. You take care.